Thanks for that, Sybil. Well, the lovely Serena Bellissimo is one of many people that suffer from celiac disease in Ireland, and I went along with her to Cleanse Within on George Street in Dublin to see if this kind of therapy was of benefit to someone with the condition. Here's how we got on. As a therapy, colon cleansing or colonic irrigation has been around since about 1500 BC. The Egyptians were the first to use it. Now, as you can see, I'm not exactly in ancient Egypt now, but it is a practice that is thriving and became very popular around the time of Princess Diana. Lady Diana was quite well known for using colon hydrotherapy on a quite regular basis to keep her figure, to keep her healthy. And this is what we're doing here again today. Now, it's not me. I'll introduce you a little bit later to our willing victim from the midday panel. But first, I'm talking to Lisa from Cleanse Within. Thank you very much for joining us today, Lisa. Now, tell me, how long have you been doing the practice here and why do people come to you for colon hydrotherapy?
Well, I'm doing it nearly 10 years. I left nursing to do it. I think it's an amazing therapy. It helps a lot of ailments in the body. Mainly, I'd say 90% of my clients come to see me because of irritable bowel, constipation, diarrhea, reflux, bloating, lethargy, fluid retention, PMS. It covers a multitude of things. It really, really helps a lot of problems.
Why is the bowel so important and why are we neglecting it so much, do you think? How important actually is that part of our body for our overall well-being?
Yeah, well, it's so important. It's the way for the body to rid toxins. If you're full of feces, full of decay, you're constantly absorbing those toxins back into the body. You've got 70 to 80% of your immune system in your large intestine. That's what you don't want, loads of bad bacteria in there. You want optimum friendly bacteria in there.
And what, Irish people in general, what are we doing wrong? What's our biggest no-no when it comes to keep bowel health?
Okay, Irish people, a lot of bread and cheese. Bread and cheese. A lot of people don't drink enough water. A lot of people are highly stressed, running around like headless chickens and just not eating regularly, grabbing something on the go. Even stress alone can constipate you. So obviously having that packaged sandwich when you're stressed, it's not going to help at all.
Now I'd like to introduce you all to the lovely Serena Bellissimo, who has decided to take part in our little experiment here. Now Serena, you actually want to do this for a specific reason. Tell us why you decided to get involved in this.
Because I get lots of back pain and lots of bloating, and I'm a celiac as well. So I think I could have, maybe I've self-diagnosed here, but I think I may have some irritable bowel as well. So I just wanted to get it all cleansed and maybe start eating properly again too.
Now Serena's a little bit nervous about what lies ahead for her, but Lisa, you're going to explain everything and what happens in this actual colon hydrotherapy session. So take it away.
No problem. Okay, you basically lie down on the treatment bed. I have a feel of your belly and I feel any areas that are of tightness, bloating, any areas that might be painful for you. And wherever I feel resistance, I know where I need to massage. So you lie down, you've got a towel over you, quite a big towel, so dignity is totally intact.
Thank God.
First of all, I lie you on your side. Now, the tube is inserted while you're lying on your left side. So you're lying like in the fetal position.
How big's the tube?
The tube is not that big. This is the tube. It basically goes in an inch and a half inside your bottom. So it's a gentle fill, release, fill, release, fill, release.
If you're tending to retain stuff around your tummy area, yeah, there is an inch loss involved in this as well.
100%. I put my heart on that. If the body is full of feces, you're full of dryness, and then with dryness becomes fluid retention. So by ridding of the dry feces, your body starts getting rid of fluid more efficiently. That's why everyone feels slimmer around the abdomen.
So there we go now.
That's the first smile.
There you go. See, you're happy now, aren't you? Now, I'm very aware it's lunchtime, so don't worry, we won't be filming any of this. We're going to go out now and let you two at it. So see you back here in an hour. Serena,
yeah.
Now you were incredibly nervous before that, but you had been suffering for quite a while. I mean, you said you were in pain and bloating because of your condition.
And it was really funny when we first walked in, the first thing she said to me, without even touching my stomach, she just went, "Wow, you're incredibly bloated." And ever since I've had that done, I've had two sessions done. I am a convert. I think it's amazing. I felt so much better. And the great thing about Lisa as well was it wasn't just about the cleansing. She supported me with some nutritional advice as well. And because I'm a celiac, you think, like a lot of gym instructors now are telling their clients, do a celiac diet because it's healthy. It's not necessarily healthy. There's a lot of high fat in them, a lot of sugar. Because remember, the gluten is the tasty stuff in food. Yeah. So they're trying to bring back the taste into the food. So it was really helpful to, I sort of did it as a kickstart as well, to sort of go, okay, well, I feel all cleansed. I couldn't believe the amount of stuff that she gets out of you. And you can't help but watch. It's gross, but you can't help but watch. But I did feel incredibly light and...
Yeah, beforehand, you didn't go just straight into it. There is a process involved, and you had to fill out a questionnaire, and you can't just run in and say, yeah, I want to have a colonic. They're like, Lisa's a nurse, so she knows what she's on about when it comes to this. What did you have to do in the days leading up to it?
I was a bit nervous doing that too, because you used the word cleanse, and I was like, oh, I'm not good at doing the cleansing. But basically, it's not a strict diet, but it's just taking out stuff like I was eating... like tubs of Nutella, so like eliminating chocolate and sweets.
Oh, my own heart. I love Nutella.
chocolate sweets, soft drinks, and just eating healthy.
Just for a few days before.
Just for 2 or 3 days. I didn't have to take anything. Afterwards, a lot of people say, you know, you're getting rid of the friendly bacteria, but you're not. You're getting rid of a little bit of the friendly bacteria, but then she put me on some probiotics as well, which is replenishing everything. And I have to admit, I never thought I'd feel this good. I know why Princess Diana got it done regularly.
Yeah. Yeah, because I've been a fan of them for quite a while. You do feel very much healthier, and a lot of people do just get it for the weight loss side of things, which
but you don't necessarily lose the weight.
You lose, like, I just find your waist, the bloat, because you have so much gas and you're eating so much crap. I mean, your bowels are in bits. You've had them done, haven't you, Fiona?
Yeah, and the first time I had it done, I did lose weight, I have to say, and I know it's not the reason, it wasn't the reason I did it, but it was, but I think I lost 5 pounds. Yeah,
they say that to be disgusting now, you can have up to 5 pounds of compacted faeces in your bowels by the time you hit your 30s, and that's just basically your plaque.
Now, it was only the first time I had done that I lost. I mean, I didn't see any weight loss after that. And to be honest, I think I've had about 4 done, and by kind of the 4th one, I felt that I wasn't really getting any benefit from them. But I would certainly recommend that everyone gets it done at least once. Because, you know, as you say, get rid of the 30 years, that have built up, or the 40 years, or whatever it is.
Yeah. One of your researchers was actually saying that sometimes when people do colonic irrigation, you would have bits of crayon and Lego coming out. Apparently, it's been in your system as a child, and you would actually swallow it as a child, and it's still sitting there 30, 40 years later.
Bicycle, really. Do you know what? When I was in Thailand, they were telling me some people passed tapeworms.
People are having their lunch, people.
Yes, we didn't show them that. I'm sure, listen, if they don't want to listen to something with this, you can be damn sure they turned off the telly by now.
I'm just thinking about the tubs of Nutella. You're brilliant. I've never met anyone else who has tubs of Nutella.
I don't anymore. Funnily enough.
How did you feel afterwards? I mean, for me, it kills, because everyone. I love carbs. Fine carbs, and they're addictive for me. But I found afterwards, your system is so much more efficient that it kind of kills that craving to a certain extent. You're more hydrated to a certain extent.
Unless you're me. Because I crave them, but I don't want them as much as... Well, I don't feel the need to go and eat them as much. I think, the craving's there, but I'm thinking... I don't want to do damage to what I've done. Like, I have a clear system now. I want to try and keep it that way. Mm. It was funny because you came in afterwards. I was so spaced out after the first one.
We didn't show that.
No, I was just, I was spaced out. And I remember walking home. I was supposed to get in a cab, but I just kept walking. And then I was at my daughter's creche like 45 minutes later because I had just kept walking. Yeah. But after the second go, I wasn't as spaced, and I did just feel, you do feel lighter because the bloating just isn't there. And when I talk about the bloating starts from up here and goes all the way down to your stomach. And up here went straight away. Down here didn't go until the second time.
But you can actually see a difference with you.
Yeah. Look great.
I was just actually looking at the very first shot of that package and to look at you now. I mean, I haven't seen you since you had that on. It's quite amazing.
Yeah. Guess where I'm going after this show? Cleansement.
And there'll be no more Nutella for you anyway. Thanks very much, Serena. And of course to Lisa, Emmanuel, and Cleanse Within for facilitating us.